I tell you what, it's going to be a slow day. I'm not going to lie. We may not catch any fish. We may not catch another fish. I don't know. But we're not after the gold, Sweatby. We're not after the quantity today when we catch all the little bitty 2, 3, 4, 5 pounders. We're actually fishing a spot where we're targeting larger fish, okay? I'm throwing bigger baits. We're in a deep hole right below a wing dam. And hold up. Is that a fish or is that log caught on my rod down there? Hang on, we'll see. I think that log down there's got my rod. We'll deal with that in a minute. But I'm already pumped up because just a little bit ago on stand day, for any of y'all that didn't see it, in the last 8 minutes of the show, I caught another pie ball. Beautiful fish. Wouldn't you know it? It was on the last rod, furthest from me. They always bite that rod. But just caught another pie ball, the 19-pounder. Beautiful, beautiful fish that we got some pictures of and got him back in the water and turned him loose so he can go up and be a giant pie ball. But the thing about it is, the spot I'm fishing, you're not going to be like hammering, getting, oh, he's a fish on, fish on, fish on, fish on. We're trying to catch something big. So we're scattering out big baits in this deep hole right below this wing dam. And it's going to be slow. It may be boring, you know, as far as fishing goes. We'll try to keep you a little pumped up. I got to get that log off that rod. It's just driving me nuts. But we'll try to keep it exciting and fun. Right before I went live, that big 14-foot rod right there, that one, it bent down and was stripping drag on it. And I got down there and grabbed it, was trying to pull it up, and he got me around a rock. That's broke off, so I'm going to have to retie that. So we just lost a fish just moments ago. I don't care because we caught a beautiful fish just a little bit ago. And don't bother me a bit. Now, if I hadn't caught nothing all day and lost that fish just then, yeah, I'd been upset. But I'm not going to be upset right now. I just can't do it. I can't do it. Oh, big rod. Oh, wait a minute. What we got going on here? Oh, crap. Oh, God. Oh, my God. I don't want to lose him. Let me get the camera turned, guys. This is a big fish. Oh, God. Come on now. Guys, I can barely move him. Come on. This is going to be a good one. I am not hung up. This is all fish. Come on. Oh, come on. Come on. I can't move him. There he comes. Come on. I'm over it. I gotta get over that big rod. Come here. Come here. Come on. Come on. Oh, crap. Come on, son. I mean, not as big as I thought, but he's good size. He just got in that current. Man, he's got three rods tangled up. That fish ain't that big. He's got in that current. He's still good size, though. Come here. Get out of there, mother lad, you idiot. Oh, come here. Come on, man. Come on. I'm tangled up in fishing rods. He ain't too bad. I'll take that one on a Sunday. What I tell you, we're going after, we're targeting the bigger fish today. I know what I'm talking about. That in there, we're going to have to weigh him in the net. He's too big for the the grippers. All right, I'm going to lay you down here gently. Don't do nothing stupid. Lay right there. He's got three rods wrapped up. That one, and that one. He made a mess. Okay. Let's see what you weigh. He's bigger than I thought. Ain't bad. Get in that net. All right. Now, my net weighs 1.6 pounds. So, y'all keep that in mind. The net weighs 1.6. Let's see what this big boy is. Man, he jammed that river cat's tackle right in my hook, right in my finger. Okay, ready? Let's do it. What you gonna be, boy? Lock. Come on. Just spinning around. Good gravy. Lock. Look, I gotta rest. He's not that big. He's probably gonna be, I'm gonna say mid 30s, but man, I'm weak. Oh, I gotta reset. Let's go. There he went. How close was I? All right. 33.76. Take off 1.6 for the net. You know, I told y'all. We're not after little bitty fish today. You thought I was just blowing smoke up your hiney hole, didn't you? No, the bite's slow, but they're out there. That's one of the ones that Richard Cluck, I guarantee you, drove through here and said, man, you got some active feeders out there. Let's get him turned loose. We're taking way too long with that. Come here, sonny boy. there. Yes, sir. Now, let's watch him swim off. Y'all want to? Don't break my arm. Come on, take off. I probably should have burped that fish. Yeah, I probably should have burped him. Look, he's swimming like a shark with his fin out of the water. See it? He'd be all right. He's going down. He gone. He gone, he gone, he gone. Now I gotta fix all that crap he messed up. Man, I got catfish boogers all over me. Catfish boogers. I gotta fix all those rods. Dadgummit. All right. Well, anyways, got three rods I gotta untangle now. Thanks a lot. Appreciate it. No, for real, I do. I appreciate it. When that rod went down, I thought I hooked a tree. I'm like, what in the crap? And he went down the bottom, and I couldn't move him. He went out there. There's a current seam right out in front of me, and he got right just inside of that current seam, and he went down to the bottom, and it was basically, he was using that current, and he was going downstream, and he was pulling drag there for a while. I had tied it up just a little bit. But I was pulling, and I thought, man, he wrapped me up in a rock. But then his head shook, and I'm like, no, he didn't. He's just putting pure power of himself combined with the power of the river, and he's stomping the crap out of me. But that's not a big fish by any means here. Absolutely love catching them. Still not quite what we're looking for. I'm looking for me to call it a big fish here. It's got to go 60 or better. 60 or better. So that fish was about halfway to where I want him to be. But he's going to get there, and I'll be here and waiting, ready to catch him again. All right, well, we just caught that fish on. I want to go over this with you real quick. We just landed that 33-pound, 33? What was he? 30, that 30-something pound fish. Okay. Right there, baby. Just get off the other line. Ancient Mariner Challenger. This is a 10-footer, guys. This one ain't no joke. This is the 10-footer. With the Ancient Mariner 6000 reel. That's what we just used on there. I do have a FOA. That's FOA line on there. Now the rig I'm using is just it was a simple breakaway rig. Of course the sinker's gone because he broke it off. But there's just a little float stuck on there. And what do we got here? What do we have here? Anybody recognize that? Do you recognize that? That is the River Cat's Tackle. Crimson red, wide gap, 8-aught hook. And that gap on that thing, it's an 8-aught hook, but it's as wide as most 9s and 10s. But that's a simple little rig right there. And I didn't have that float. Look here, there's my swivel. And that's all the leader. I don't even have a foot of leader on there. That's probably, what, 10 inches? The whole rig is only 10 inches long to the swivel. So that is right off the bottom, right off the bottom. But it is floating up just a little bit, okay? It's getting it just off the bottom. Because one thing I've noticed on these fish, when me and Richard come check them out, a lot of them, they'll be paddled up, but they're having their heads just like inches off the bottom. So I thought, you know what? I'll make a rig that keeps that bait just inches off the bottom. Well, it caught that fish. we started this live stream out explaining that our goal today was throw some bigger baits in a bigger hole right below a wing dam, where I know for a fact that some of these monster catfish hang out. And we caught a monster today, maybe to some people. I'm not calling a monster a 30-something pounder, not for this location. This particular hole right here, dude, I pulled 50s and 60s out of here like crazy. You know, well, I say like crazy. Consistently. until it hits 50 or 60 pounds, I'm not considering it a really big fish. 30 pounder is a great fish, though. For a lot of places, it is about as big as you're going to get. Not here. But we're targeting the bigger fish today. That was the whole point of the live stream today. The Mississippi River's dropping. We're going for that drought stage again. What do I do when that happens? Okay. I find the deepest, darkest hole I can find, because those fish are going to head for deep water when that water's dropping real fast like that, because they don't want to get trapped in no shallow crap. You know what I'm saying? They'll move out of there. Now, at nighttime, they'll venture back up in there to feed, but they're not going to spend extended periods of time here. Now, I'm not giving you information about your fishing spot. I'm talking about here. This is what happens. So don't think I'm telling you how to fish your spot. I'm not. I'm just telling you what we're doing here in this location right now. That's how it works in this spot. When that water starts dropping real fast, they get out of there. They go out to the main channel and hang out at the edge of that fast current. They'll find the deepest hole they can get to, because they figure, okay, if this river's going to dry up, I'm going to be in the last spot that goes dry. That's where they head for. And that's where we're at right now. We pulled a couple of decent-sized fish out here today. Could I have caught them down there in the shallow water during the daytime? Maybe. I'm betting no. I think you're going to catch the little 2 and 3 and 5 pounders and catch those. Like yesterday, during the tournament to raise money for J.G. Hill, I caught a little tiny flathead. The hook wasn't even in his mouth. He just had all the bait, and it was so big, he couldn't spit it out. And I reeled him up. Then we got a 3-pound blue, and we got a 14-pound blue. Okay? Not big fish. Those are not big fish by any means for this river. So we said, you know what, today, I said, you know what, I'm going to go to that deep hole down by the wing dam. It's going to take a lot of work to get there. I was actually going to fish this yesterday, but I had no desire to travel through the woods and them weeds at 6 o'clock in the morning. Not going to do it. We may fish this spot next Saturday during the tournament. I don't know. Because it's going to be nighttime. And these catfish move out of this hole and move up in the shallows to feed at nighttime. So I got to juggle the pros and the cons of it and decide, what do you want to do to attack this situation? And we'll figure it out. Ooh, that went a whack on that 14-footer. Just got a bump. He got a bumpity bump. Oh, there was no Lisa. What's up, Lisa? You got something for me? Oh, yes, you do. On the Lisa rod, baby. I hate standing on these rocks. I absolutely do. We got another fish on down there. Come up out of that deep crap. Man, he's way down on the bottom. He's deep. Come here. He's still on that fast current. Oh, there he goes. A little bit of head shaking going on. Oh. There he is out there. He's probably going to be a teeter. That was on shad. Come on now. Yeah, I'm pretty sure he's going to be a tainer. Come here. Come here. Get in that net. Get in that net. That's number three. That's on the catfish regulators Lisa rod. We just threw that out with a shad on it. Well, let's see what we got here. And there's that sinker guy. He's not bad. He's a pretty decent little fish. Let's get a quick weight on him, get him turned loose. Lay there, behave, don't hurt yourself. Don't move. I'll be right back. I think he's small enough we can use fish grips on him. He's borderline though. You know what? I'm going to put him in the net because he's borderline. I generally don't, put fish grips on anything over 20 pounds. Anything over 20, I'll put it in the net. I don't believe he'll go 20. I'm thinking more like 17, 18 maybe. Come on, man. Whew. I said it figured it's 17 or 18. That's 20.44. Take off 1.6 pounds for the net. Not bad. Get a quick look at him. He ate my knuckles up. We'll get made up out there. That's three today. One on stand day, two for you guys right here, right now. Not a bad day. And like I said, we're fishing for bigger quality fish. Right there. Nice, nice, nice. I like it. Beautiful Mississippi River catfish. Let's go ahead and turn him loose. We're going to turn him loose right here. You ready to go? We start his tail a little bit. Come on. Are you gonna get that? Oh, there he goes, there he goes. Oh yeah. There he goes. He flopped that tail and took off. And bit me one more time before he left. Had to bite me one more time. That fish took a little bit longer. He come out of that deep, deep, deep hole. And I did pull him up kind of quick. Probably a little quicker than I should have. But he's fine. I sit there holding him. And he started moving his tail a little bit. And then he chomped down on my hand. And when he did, he chopped again and I let go, and he spun around and flipped that tail, and he was gone like a torpedo. Gone, gone, gone. So let's see what we got left in the bait box. Do we have any shad left? Wait. Oh, we do. There's a shad. Wait, let me look in here. There's another one. We've got two shad. Oh, we've got three shad. There's another shad. I thought we were out of shad. We are not out of shad. Glory be, glory be. Let's nip that tail off there. Do some slices in him. Just like that. Now, like I showed you guys earlier, but I'll show you again. I'm taking that whole shad, I don't think it, and I'm taking a knife and I'm just cutting some slits out there. But I'll hook him through the head up here and throw that whole shad out. Danny, explain what a piebald is. Okay. A piebald is a subspecies of an albino. They're actually more rare than albino. If you took an albino fish, which is solid white, I mean white, white, white. They're white as a sheet of paper, sometimes even brighter. Now you take black, real dark black patches, and you put them in just odd positions on their body and odd shapes and stuff. A piebald is basically an albino with black spots on it. It'll have different colored patches and stuff. You go check out some of them on my channel. I've got some really cool ones on there. I got one that's got a question mark on his head. Everybody knows that fish. Caught one today on Two Stand Show. But I caught two last year. One of them we called the, what did they call that fish? Oh, Venom. Because he looked like Venom. He had, Venom's got two big white eyes. This thing had two big white patches on its head. It looked like Venom from the Marvel comics. And then I had the Zorro fish, which I call on Creole's channel. It was a piebald that was all black, and he had a white Z on his side. That was El Zorro, which our name was. But I've been luckier, and I'm saying it ain't got nothing to do with skill. If there ain't no bragging to this, I have been blessed, blessed, blessed. One of the most luckiest fishermen that I know when it comes to catching these piebalds. Over the last, it's 12 years now. Over the last 12 years, I've caught 18 of them, counting today. And that is absolutely unheard of. And for me to not take that as an absolute blessing, it shouldn't. The odds of that happening are astronomical. There's no way I should have that many piebalds on the board. But for some reason, they love stupid people. Yeah, I used to say, how do you catch piebalds? Well, first you had to eat a lot of lead paint chips when you were a kid, because that attracts them for some reason. They love dumb people. They're like, oh, look at that idiot up on the bank. Hey, go find a suck. He's going to freak out when he sees you. I promise he is. And I do. I freak out every time I see him. I'm like, oh, my God, it's so cool. There's another piebald. But I've got several good piebalds on my channel. Y'all go check them out if you want to. If you don't want to, that's fine, too. I ain't trying to push nobody nowhere. I'm just saying the door's open and you're welcome to come in anytime you want. Had a great day today. I'll say it again. I hope I'm not sounding braggadocious. I just want you guys to see the fish. I'm not trying to get attention for myself. I'm really not. I just want you to see the fish. But if you didn't see it, go back, check out the stand day from earlier today. And in the last like 8 or 10 minutes of the show, I caught a really nice fish that I'm proud of. One that I'd love to share with you and let you see it, okay? And we caught a couple of nice fish today. We got a 33-pounder and a 20-something pounder. Not a bad day. Not a bad day on the river. And what made it really, really great is you guys in chat hanging out with me. I started out reading chat as much as I could, but you guys know me, and you know how I am. Once I get to talking, okay, that's all you're going to get. That's the Daddy Stone Show. He's going to sit there, and I'm not ignoring you. I'm just trying to put on a show for you and let you enjoy a little stupidity. You know what I'm saying? But thank you guys for being here with me today. It's been a great, great day. Let's do it the way we always do it. You ready? Here we go. All right. You're my brothers, you're my sisters, and you're my catfish family. God bless each and every one of you, because you know that Danny Stone loves you. And love you being here. And thank you for being here. God bless you. We love you. And we'll see you again real soon. Bye, everybody.